Hello students, welcome to EPG Pathshala. I'm Dr. Sudhanshu Joshi from Dune University, Dehradun. Today we are going to talk on module MIS and Decision Support System under the paper Management Information System. After completing this module, you should be able to understand the types of decisions and their requirement in business organization. To understand the concept, definition, and the scope of decision support system. To understand interrelationship between various information systems and their applications. Let us explore the definition of decision support system. Decision support systems, or DSS, are interactive software-based systems intended to help managers in decision making by accessing large volumes of information generated from various related information systems involved in organizational business processes, such as office automation system, transaction processing system, etc. In simple words, decision support system means helping managers in decision-making process in order to achieve organizational objectives most appropriately. A decision support system helps in decision making but does not necessarily give the decision itself. The decision makers comply useful information from raw data, document, personal knowledge and or business model to identify and solve problems and to make decisions. Types of decisions. There are mainly two types of decisions. One is programmed decisions and second is non-programmed decisions. Diet method for handling the problem. Taxonomies of DSS. Various technologists differentiate DSS in different forms. Houghton Schedler differentiate DSS in three forms, namely active decision support system, passive decision support system, cooperative decision support system, whereas Daniel Power differentiates DSS in five forms, namely communication-driven decision support system, data-driven decision support system, document-driven decision support system, knowledge-driven decision support system, and model-driven decision support system. Taxonomy of DSS. Houghton Schedler taxonomies. Active decision support system. Active decision support system is a system which brings explicit solution to the problems arise in the decision making process. Passive decision support system. A passive decision support system is a system that aids in the process of decision making but that cannot bring out explicit decision solutions or suggestions. Corporate decision support system. A cooperative decision support system allows for an interactive process between human and systems towards the achievement of a consolidated solution. The decision makers can modify or refine the decision or suggestions provided by the system before sending them back to the system for validation. Likewise, the system again improves and refines the suggestions of the decision makers and send them back to the process for validation. Let us also explore further taxonomies like Daniel Power taxonomies, which defines as communication-driven decision support system as one category and data-driven decision support system as second category. Communication-driven decision support systems. In the communication-driven decision support system, decisions of a problem is taken by more than one person. It involves cooperation and support of individuals. In this system, different people are working on a shared task. Whereas, in the case of data-driven decision support system, it uses internal data to solve the problem arises in decision support process and sometimes it is also uses external data for it. We have further classification as per taxonomy. One is document-driven decision support system, and second is knowledge-driven decision support system. If we talk about the document-driven decision support system, it manages, retrieves, and manipulates unstructured information in a variety of electronic formats. Whereas knowledge-driven decision support system support system provided specialized problem-solving expertise stored as facts, rules, procedures, or in a similar structure. Modern-driven decision support system is one of the classification which uses various models to provide optimal solution to the problems arises in decision support process. That the model itself may be statistical model, financial model, or simulation model. Model-driven DSS uses data and parameters provided by users to assess decision makers in analyzing a solution. We have further taxonomies. Some other taxonomies are status inquiry systems, data analysis systems. So if you define the statistical inquiry systems, it helps in taking operational, manager level, or middle level management decisions. For example, daily schedule of jobs to machines or machines to operators. Whereas data analysis systems, it needs comparative analysis and makes use of formula or an algorithm. For example, cash flow analysis or inventory modeling or inventory analysis, etc. We have another taxonomy-based system which is called information analysis system. In this system, data is analyzed and information report is generated. For example, sales analysis, accounts received systems, market analysis, etc. Attributes of a decision support system. Following are some attributes of a decision support system, namely adaptive and flexibility. Second, high level of interactivity. Third, easy to use. Fourth, efficiency and effectiveness. Fifth, complete control by decision makers. Sixth, ease of development. Seventh, extendability. Eighth, support for modeling and analysis. Ninth, support for data access. 10th, standalone, integrated, and web-based. Characteristic of decision support system. A DSS helps managers in decision-making process at various manager level, ranging from executive to line managers. Decision support system helps not only individuals, but also a group of people because it is able to find out solutions to less structured problems. Less structured problems often requires involvement of several individuals from different departments and organization level. It also helps managers in interdependent or sequential decisions. It supports variety of decision processes and styles. Decision support systems are adaptive over time. Let us explore the multidimensional view of data. A multidimensional view of data provides the basis for analytical processing through flexible access to corporate data. It enables users to analyze data across any dimension at any level of aggregation with required functionality and ease. It supports complex calculations also. It provides support for complex calculation because OLAP software provides a range of powerful computational methods. Time intelligence is again is a powerful attribute of the same, which is used to judge the performance of almost any analytical application over time. For example, this month versus last month, or this month versus same month last year. These comparisons may be easily defined in an OLAP systems. Now let us explore the types of online analytical processings. Online analytical processing has three types, namely multidimensional online analytical processing, which is rational online analytical processing and hybrid. Second type is relational online analytical processing, and third is hybrid online analytical processing. We can define multiple or multidimensional online analytical processing as traditional mode of OLAP analysis,
MOLAP or multi-dimensional online analytical processing stores all FIMO multi-dimensional cubes, and it is not fundamentally a relational database. The advantage of this mode is to provide excellent query performance, and the cubes are built for the fast data retrieval. All calculations are pre-generated when the cube is created and can be easily applied while querying the data. The disadvantage of this model are that it can handle only a limited amount of data, since all calculations have been pre-built while cube was created. The cube cannot be derived from a large volume of data. This deficiency can be bypassed by including only summary level calculation while constructing the cubes. The second category is relational online analytical processing, or ROLAP. It is another important type of online analytical processing. The underlying data in this model is stored in a relational database. Since data is stored in relational database, this model gives appearance of traditional OLAP. And the advantage of this model is it can handle a large amount of data and can leverage all the functionalities of relational database. This disadvantage are that the performance is slow, and each ROLAP reports is an SQL query with all limitation of the gen. Hybrid online analytical processing, HOLAP, it is the third classification or third type of OLAP. Hybrid online analytical processing technology tries to combine the strength of above two models. For summary type information, HOLAP leverages cube technology, and for drilling down into details, it uses the ROLAP model. It offers high scalability of ROLAP and faster computation of MOLAP. HOLAP servers allows storing the large data volumes of detailed information.
Steps for decision support systems. According to Simon, the decision making process is a four-phase process consisting of intelligence, phase number one. Second phase is design. Third phase is choice. Fourth phase is implementation. Phase first, intelligence, means searching for conditions that cause for decisions. Phase second, design, it means inventing, developing, and analyzing solutions. Phase third, choices, it means selecting a course of action. Phase fourth, implementation, it means adapting the selected course of action. Figure second illustrate decision making process, where problem or an opportunity is identified. Intelligence phase will structure that problem or opportunity into environmental reports. Designing phase will convert into overt alternative solutions, whereas choices phase compare the alternative solutions, and implementation phase puts selection into actions. Components of decision support system. A decision support system has five components, namely data, models, knowledge or intelligence, users, and user interface. A brief description of these components is as under: data. As we know, decision support system provides solution to the problems. Every problem requires data from many sources. Models. Models are used to manipulate data. Models may be standard or customized. Third component could be knowledge or intelligence. Systems sometimes have a knowledge or intelligence component. Fourth component is users. Users are another important component. And the fifth component is user interface. It's the last component of decision making. Users are responsible end users at different level of management, and user interface could be the hardware and software plugged into so that user can access over the decision support system. Architecture of decision support system. We have a two-way architecture of decision support system, where data is modeled and knowledge is extracted out of data through a user interface, and with a mediocre models, we can generate relevant data out of it. So it's a cyclic process where decision support system helps management to make decisions and to generate relevant knowledge. computerized tool for decision support system. Following are the computerized tools for decision support system, including databases and database management systems. Data management, it includes database management systems, extraction, transformation, and load systems and data warehouses. The term database management system can be defined as an organized collection of data. A database management system is a computer software application that interacts with the users, other applications, and the database itself to capture and analyze data. DBMS includes MySQL, PostgreSQL, SQL, Mongo Database, Microsoft SQL Server, Oracle, Sybase, SAP HANA, and IBM DB2. Data warehouse structure. Virtualization. It includes geographical information systems, or GIS, which can be defined as a computer system for capturing, storing, checking, and displaying data related to positions on Earth's surface. GIS can show many different kinds of data on one map. This enables people to more easily see, analyze, understand patterns and relationship. Strategy and performance management includes BPM, Business Process Management, and Business Activity Management, BAM. Let us explore the definition and scope of Business Performance Management, which is also known as BPM. Business Performance Management is a set of performance management, which is an analytical process that enables the management of the organization to achieve one or more pre-selected goals. Business Performance Management is also known as Corporate Performance Management, or CPM, and also known by the term called Enterprise Performance Management, EPM. Business Performance Management has three major activities as its part. One is selection of goal. Second is measurement of the progress of the organization against those goals selected. Third is intervention made by managers in light of this information with a view to improve future performance against these goals. We have another terminology called Business Activity Management, BAM. Business Activity Management is also known as Business Activity Monitoring. Business Activity Management means proactively define and analyze opportunities, risk in an enterprise to maximize profitability and to improve the efficiency. Business Activity Management utilizes advanced technology for the same. The term Business Activity Monitoring was originally coined by the analyst at Gartner Incorporation. It simply means aggregation, analysis, and presentation of the real-time information about activities inside organizations and involving customers and partners. The goal of Business Activity Management are to provide real-time information about the results and status of various operations, processes, and transactions. Let us also explore how report status tracking has taken place. It involves online analytical processing and execution information systems are took into account. Online analytical processing, OLAP, under this approach, answering multi-dimensional analytical inquiry will be shifted in computing instead of doing it manually. Multi-dimensional analysis of the data analytical processes that the group data is doing is categorized into two categories. One is data dimension and second is measurement of that data. The term OLAP was created as a slight modification of traditional database term called Online Transaction Processing, OLTP. Typically, application of OLAP includes business reporting for sales, marketing, management reports, business process management, BPM, budgeting and forecasting, financial reporting, and similar areas with new applications coming up such as agriculture. Features of Online Analytical Processing, OLAP. Following are the key features of online analytical processing, including multidimensional views of data, support for complex calculations, and time intelligence.
Software. appropriate software selection is vital for effective EIS. Therefore, the software components and how they are integrated the data into one systems become important. Following are some prerequisites for software selection. Software must be test handled software because documents are typically text based. The software must be graphical based because graphics can turn volumes of text and statistics into visual information for executives. Typical graphic types are time series chart, scatter diagram, maps, bar chart, etc. The software must be model based because models are very helpful in routine statistical and financial analysis. We have another way of interpreting thing is user interface. User interface simply means interacting between machines and a human being. An EIS must be efficient to retrieve relevant data for decision makers. So the user interface is very important. Several type of interfaces can be available to the EIS structure, such as scheduled reports, question and answers, command language, natural language, input and output. The telecommunication under EIS is taken care as a decentralized one. And with becoming the current trend in the companies that telecommunication will provide a pivot role in the network information system, transmitting data from one place to another has become critical for establishing a reliable data network. Telecommunication made it easy to access the distributed data across the network.
Executive Information System. An executive information system, also known as executive support system, is a type of management information system that provide necessary information to the managers and help them in decision-making process. It provides easy access to internal and external information relevant to organization goal. It is commonly considered as a specialized form of decision support system. In general, EIS are enterprise-wide DSS that help top-level executives to analyze, compare, highlight trends in important variables so that they can monitor performance and identify opportunities and problems. Various components of executive information system could be hardware, software, user interface, and telecommunication. Hardware. When talking about computer hardware for an EIS environment, we should focus on the hardware that meets executive's need. The executive needs must be defined before the hardware can be selected. The basic hardware needed for typical EIS includes four components. First, input data entry devices. These devices allow the executive to enter, verify, and update data immediately. CPU. CPU stands for Central Processing Unit. The central processing unit or CPU is the most important component because it controls the other computer system components. Data storage files. The executives can use this part to save useful business information. And this part also helps the executive to search historical business information easily. Output devices. Output devices are very important because executives can save their important data in these devices. They can utilize this information later. Output devices refers to the visual output devices such as monitors or printers.
Software. Appropriate software selection is vital for effective EIS. Therefore, the software components and how they are integrated the data into one systems become important. Following are some prerequisites for software selection. Software must be test handled software because documents are typically text based. The software must be graphical based because graphics can turn volumes of text and statistics into visual information for executives. Typical graphic types are time series chart, scatter diagram, maps, bar chart, etc. The software must be model based because models are very helpful in routine statistical and financial analysis.
We have another way of interpreting thing is user interface. User interface simply means interacting between machines and a human being, and EIS must be efficient to retrieve relevant data for decision makers. So the user interface is very important. Several type of interfaces can be available to the EIS structure, such as scheduled reports, question and answers, command language, natural language, input and output. The telecommunication decentralized one, becoming the current trend in the companies that telecommunication will provide a pivot role in the network information system, transmitting data from one place to another, has become critical for establishing a reliable data network. Telecommunication made it easy to access the distributed data across the network. Advantages and disadvantages of EIS. Advantages of EIS. Following are the main advantages of executive information system. It is very easy to use. No extensive computer experience is required for operations. It is helpful to provide necessary information on a timely basis as per their requirements. It increases efficiency of the decision makers. It helps to save time because it provides necessary information on time. Therefore, management can make decisions promptly. Whereas EIS is also having some disadvantages, including the following disadvantages. All data and information are depending upon system. It incurs very high implementation cost. System may become slow because a large amount of data is stored in it. For a small organization, it is not possible to implement executive support system due to very high cost. Business analytics. It includes text mining, data mining, and web mining. Whereas text mining is a process of analyzing huge text data to retrieve the information from it, the basic measures for text retrieval are as under. Precision. This is the percentage of retrieved documentation that are in fact relevant in the query. Recall. This is percentage of documents that are relevant to the query and were in fact retrieved. Recall is basically the formal definition of precision. Second component is data mining. It is a practice of examining large pre-existing database in order to generate new information. Generally, data mining, sometimes called data or knowledge discovery, is a process of analyzing data from different perspectives and summarizing it into useful information. The information that can be used to increase revenue, cuts cost, or both. Data mining software is one of a number of analytical tools for analyzing data. It allows users to analyze data from many different dimensions or angles, categorize it, and summarize the relationship identified. Web mining. Web mining means mining World Wide Web. World Wide Web is huge, widely distributed. Global information service centers for news, advertisements, management, education, government, and many other information services. The web also contains dynamic collection of happening information and web page access. There are some challenges in web mining, including the web seems to be too huge. Therefore, data warehousing and data mining is very difficult. The web is a highly dynamic source of information and only a small portion of information on the web is useful or relevant. Now, why the companies are using computerized decision support system? The following could be the possible reasons why the companies want to use computerized decision support system, including changing economy, many business operations, global competition, e-commerce for making prompt decisions, for making high quality decisions, and to improve the productivity.
So students, let's now summarize what we have learned in this module. Active decision support system, which is a kind of system which brings explicit solution to the problems arises in decision making processes. We also understood corporate decision support system or cooperative decision support system, which allows an iterative process between human and system towards the achievement of the consolidated solution. We understood the basic definition of data, databases, DBMS, where data, databases, and DBMS are interlinked. Database management system is a computerized software application that interacts with users and other application through data as a center, pivot element, and it captures data and analyzes that data for future decision making. We also gone through the terminology of DSS, models, ODBMS, object-oriented databases also. We discussed about passive decision support system and its applicability into a business organization. We also understood the term called RDBMS. How RDBMS has been used in structuring the decisions at the departmental as well as the organization level. Thank you.